Hi, I'm Rich at New Life Scientific, and today I want to show off this beautiful machine here. And it's beautiful because I actually went through and refurbished it. And I want to kind of start off some of the options and the control panel here. And originally this machine actually had the older generation software that was run through PLC units, and it didn't even have a controller in it. So what happened then is SP Scientific actually sells an upgrade kit that you can actually upgrade the whole machine, but it's actually a little bit of work, but I order it from them. And of course here you can see the verification sticker. They actually take the serial number right from the machine, and then they kind of build the controller to this machine. So then they ship it to me and I install it. But first we're going to cover some of the options of this machine. And the first option here I want to go over is under the F2 button. And it's this ISO valve, and what that is, it's an isolation valve, and it's just simply controlled over here on 1 and 2. You can see it move back from closed to open. And if you don't know what that valve is, it's actually a huge valve that just sits right behind this panel, and you got a big 6-inch pipe that comes up out of the condenser chamber and then pipes right into the side of the chamber over here. And in the middle of that is a huge valve, and it runs by pneumatics. And when you hit the switch, it opens up a valve and then it runs the pneumatics, and it isolates that whole chamber away from the condenser. And that's just if you need to keep a vacuum under that side and you need to perhaps drain this and get it in a defrost. So you can just leave that kind of locked in. Nothing's happening. It's maintaining the temperatures, maintaining the vacuum, and that way you can do anything you need on this side, and then just resume operations, open the valve back up. So that's one option this has. The other option this has is the stoppering option, and you can kind of see it in the trays over here if you know what you're looking for. So I'm just going to hit run the button over here, and you can see, and it's a little bit noisy, pretty typical. So what it does is just clamps all your samples up and gets it ready for freezing. So that's a really nice option. And as many shelves as this has with that stop ring, this is about as big a unit as you can get before you go to full scale production. So this is right before that, even to do some full scale production maybe. So that's a really nice option on the machine too. And of course the recipe builder in it, if you're familiar with the wizard, we do have some software that just actually tracks and documents all the, I think it runs every 2 minutes, it runs, can run the full recipe out so that you can see, you know, make sure every process was done accurately. So I've actually ran that and ran a recipe, and works just flawlessly. And you can see the condenser right now is at negative 88.6, which is even over what the temperature is, you know, when we went in and rebuilt the refrigeration on that. So we pretty much go in, replace filter dryers, and do some nitrogen purges and pressure test the whole system, refill it with refrigerants, and get it back up to spec. And also you can see we're down to 29 millitorr micron in the vacuum, which is really nice, pulling under a deep vacuum. This will actually get down to 15, you know, if it sits long enough. But we actually put a brand new vacuum pump in, which we're going to look at here in a little bit. Because I want to point out some nice options that I actually use, and that is the evacuator and then the pump. So we're going to actually look at behind here. I actually put a hinge door, and that's something that I add also. So that gives us really good access to the vacuum pump over here. Now, you are going to need to change the oil once in a while. So that's why we give the evacuator here. And this is just my personal evacuator that I use for the demo here, but you will get a brand new one in a box. So it's pretty easy. I picked this one because it has a little kind of a holder here to kind of catch your drips. So I take that and I just pull off this plug here and put that on, open the valve here, and then you would just simply pump all your oil out of the pump. So once you get all the oil out, you just simply shut it again, unhook this, put this back on, and that's just to keep any drips there from dripping down. Now, how do we get the oil back in? Well, the same way we pump oil out, we pump it back in. And that's why I actually build in these quick connects here. So here you have a dispensing pump here and you have a quick connect there. Both sides are valved so that when you go to unplug it, you will not drip oil or oil out of both ends because they're sealed. So that is really handy. Now, doesn't guarantee you might get one drip, but so you just, you know, open up the new gallon of oil. We include this, everything you need. Then you screw that on there. And then of course, pop that out and then you're ready to pump in your new oil. So like I said, otherwise it would be really hard to get up underneath that and fill that. So it's just nice tucked away, hidden down here. And also the hydraulic system for the stop ring is also down here. You shouldn't ever have to do anything with that. It does have an oil reservoir, but because it's hardly ever used, it's very used very little when you're running the machine, because you might only use it once every couple days. So that's something that hardly ever goes bad. So but it is housed down there, but we can just close the door, and that's how quick an oil change actually is. And we're using the exact same quick connect here as VirTis uses already on their drain. So same thing on your drain in here when you're defrosting, after you evacuate or drain the vacuum, plug in here, which we give you the plug, and then you also can drain your condenser that way. So we put new door seals on here. Sometimes we replace plexiglass too. It looks like this one's it looks like it's a new door there. And then up here again, another quick connect valve. And this also has valves on it. So what this is if you want to backfeed nitrogen in it rather than ambient air, you can just put a nitrogen tank over here or any kind of gases of that, and then plug it in here and just run it at really low PSI. So when you hit the vacuum release, rather than just have an ambient air pull in here, you can have some nitrogen that keeps the chamber drier and free of ambient. So that's what this plug is here. And again, this is the up and down for the stoppering. And like I said, the F2 here gets you to that option on the isolation valve. Now, the recipe builder, running this here, I've got another video that I've done on those, so I'm not going to get into any of that. But the main thing is about the machine, and it's great running now. It's thoroughly gone through, new vacuum pump, new vacuum hoses, refrigeration gone through. Everything's been stripped off. All the panels have been stripped off and repainted, and all the valves have been added. So this particular machine didn't actually show a lot of use on it when we got it. The chamber was extremely clean. Both chambers are extremely clean, so very little signs of hard use or corrosiveness at all. So I was really happy with this one, and I'm really happy to see it get a new home. So if you got any questions on this machine, I'm Rich at New Life Scientific. You can call us here and ask me anything. If you have a recipe that you want me to put in and run that recipe on this machine, even if you got a product that you want me to run in this machine, I can definitely do it. You can ship it here, we can put it in, I can build the recipe, and I can data log it and send you the data if you want. I've done that in the past. So we're here to get your project up and going. So appreciate you watching, and give us a call. Thanks.